Hi, it's Richard Boutwell, and I'm going to be demonstrating how to use the QTR Stepwedge tool with the actual calibration step using the Tiffen or KodaK Q-13 target. So this is what your target will look like. And if you can, you want to get measurements for this white step, the M step, and the 19 step. You want the lab values, the lab L values. So I've done that with an actual densitometer so that when we actually go to the software, we can type it in and adjust to the known values. If you don't have that, don't worry. I'll give you some default values to use. So I'm going to be measuring a simple 21-step target here. And this is the same for digital negatives as well as just positive prints. But we want to position the target, the calibration target, directly above our step wedge, something like that. And place that inside the scanner. And now we can, I'm using view scan. So let's open up view scan and do our preview. Now you don't need to do the whole scan, you can just use a little sample area, but you do want to have a little bit of border and you do want these A through 19 here. I'll just use a little bit of space at the bottom as well. Actually, you can also, if you have any kind of notes on the bottom of your scan or a piece of paper, include that in the scan as well. And we'll hit scan. Now in view scan, I'm using the professional options here. We're saving to a file, 16-bit with 300 DPI. And then go to your color tab. We're gonna say color balance is none. We don't want any adjustment to this. That's why we're using that Tiffen target. The curve low should be 0.25, curve high 0.75, and then brightness and everything should just be set to 1. We don't want to adjust these at all. The output I'm just saving as a TIFF. So TIFF file. You just want to make sure you're not saving a JPEG or a PDF. You want a TIFF. Then I also have a default folder, and that is just a folder I used for this demo on the desktop. You're going to want to put those within your measurement file folder for whatever kind of setup you have there. So before we can actually use the Stepwedge tool, we need to go to the internet and we can go to downloads. So, and we want the Stepwedge tool here. So that's gonna download a zip folder and unpack it for you. See, I have one in here already. If you click on it, it'll actually open straight to where we want it to go. Now we need to drag that into Photoshop so that we can have it from the scripts menu. So we'll just open up a new Finder window. Go to Applications, Photoshop, Presets, and scroll down to Scripts. And then we're going to drag, or can copy this from here into this folder. And it will replace the one that's in there. And you do need to authenticate with your password. And with that done, we'll need to open Photoshop. So we'll go and open the scan we just made. So desktop, Stepwedge demo, there's the scan we just made. And we'll rotate, so image, counterclockwise, full screen, so F for full screen, and C for crop. So I'm just gonna use the crop tool to do the rotation. Doesn't have to be exact, but we want it just a little bit better. And that's really good. Now, before we actually go to the Stepwedge tool, we need to grab the rectangular marquee. So in the toolbar, the second one at the top, or M for marquee. And we'll select that Tiffen scale. So you want to start right at the outside edge of the white patch and end at the black patch there. So we'll go File, Scripts, QTR Stepwedge Tool. And this is where we'll need those values. So I've already typed mine in for this target. If you don't have these values, you're gonna wanna use 97 for the white point, 51 for the mid gray, and 10 for the black. That's gonna give you a good ballpark. So we'll do the calibration step now. And we'll say continue. So it's gonna give you what it adjusted the input and output points for. Say okay. And it's gonna make a second layer here for the Stepwedge tool sample data. So if you turn that off, you can see the original values or the original scan and then what it's been adjusted to. So we'll hit deselect and we'll get the marquee tool again. And now we're going to select the actual samples here that we want to measure. And you don't have to be exact with the selection. You just want to start on the outside of the first one and end on the outside or separator of the last one. Then we'll go to File, Scripts, Stepwedge Tool again. And now it knows it's done the calibration step. It knows it's in the QTR Stepwedge sample data layer. And we'll default to 21 steps and say Read Steps. And it's going to give you a little window with a list here that's real hard to read. But we'll say Save Data. And I'm going to resave it as the name of the scan, which is just today's date. That's the default for view scan. And 21x1. It's a 21 step target. Sometimes I actually do like to save the TIFF. So let's resave it. So we have the original with the set of measurements there. And that's just going to go into the Stepwedge tool demo file. So there's the measurements and the scan. So what are we going to do with those now? We're going to open up the Profiler Pro app and we're going to hit the Command 2 for linearization. And either go to open measurement file and select the scan there. So you can see there's a little bit of variation at the bottom. That's where we'll come in here and adjust that. Or actually you see here how there's like a reversal at the very end. We can just adjust this as well. So we might just say this is 11.39. So if you did want to edit some of these values, there's not really a need to, except if the ending point is a little bit lighter than the point above it. So now we need to open the quad file we want to linearize. This is the one actually printed. So we'll hit open. And as you open that, it's going to graph the original quad curve. But as soon as you adjust our smoothing sliders or adjust any of these manual points here, it'll recalculate the linearization and apply that to the quad curve and graph that out. And now we can just save the quad curve. And I'll say linear shadow version 3. Because we can save over the version 2. Replace that. And now after we save something to that quad folder, we do need to rerun the install command. So we're rerun the install command, and there is our new curve right there. And now we're ready to print. So then we just go to print tool, grab whatever image, grab the curve, and print.